a specific question I want you to challenge John's claim is that, well, you know, there's been some warming, and we're going to, in a minute, I want to press each of you to talk about how much, because magnitudes matter a great deal, I think, in, particularly when you get to the policy implications. But there's been most, I think there was a real genuine consensus from people that the climate is warmer today than it was 40 years ago today. Yeah. And then the crucial question is, how much warmer and why? John says we can't measure why it's warmer, dividing it between disentangling human versus natural causes. I don't think you agree with that.
I don't agree with that. I agree with that on a 10 or 15 year time scale. I don't agree with it on a 50 year time scale. The fact is that most of the changes we see in climate on these longer time scales are forced. And there are a variety of things that force it. It's not just greenhouse gases. There's solar variability. There's cooling of the planet demonstrably when volcanoes erupt. And there's cooling of the planet that's caused demonstrably, I think, by us through aerosols and things. The fact of the matter is that solar output, which has been measured very carefully for a few decades, has, if anything, been going down. This warming that we've seen in the last 40 years, I would say with 95% confidence, and 95% of my colleagues agree, has been caused by greenhouse gases going up. Now, is there a chance that John's right and it's not, or that, whether regardless of how John feels about it, it's not going? Yes, there is, okay? This is what risk is. If you sit here and say, I need a complete guarantee that we're taking a risk before I do anything, you're not treating this problem of risk the same way you treat any other part of risk. If someone said to you, if I said to you, I'm going to let my toddler cross the street unless you can guarantee with 98% certainty that that toddler won't get run down, I'm not going to be very comforted, right? That's the problem we're dealing with. Can I prove absolutely in a court of law? Probably not, but to the satisfaction of 97% of my colleagues, yes.
John?
That 97% is a canard, I think. That is a very simple question about, do humans contribute to climate change, is the root and meaning of that question, which I would agree with. So I'm in the 97%. Like I said, we can't tell why it is warming. But one of the tools that you can use to untangle this is a climate model. And so we put CO2, extra CO2 in the model and see how it warms. Well, using the same amount of CO2 putting in the model that is actually in the real world turns out to produce, on average, models that are 3 times warmer than what has actually happened. So my claim is, whatever is happening in the world, at least the climate models are overdoing it. It's very clear there. There's no question about that, because that's what the evidence and the numbers show. And so I don't see the real prominent things that probably are happening with negative feedbacks and internal variability, just the way the internal physics of the thing works, can lead to rises and falls in temperature. And so they have happened in the past, and it's hard to convict carbon dioxide of committing a crime if he can look back and say, but this has happened before and I wasn't there.